Hello guys, welcome back to episode number 5. Last week there was no upload as I was busy with other stuff, but that week can be summarized in 2 words, quite frustrating. And basically I had a lot of work to do, so I was stressed mentally, and I was also stressed physically as I was feeling like my body was giving out, I was tired, and it feels like I was making no progress. Second week I spent in Hamburg, I had no vacation, I was doing mobile working, and I also got one of these co-working spaces. The one I was at was called Hamburger Ding. It's on a very famous street known as Reeperbahn. If you ever consider using a co-working office, I can definitely recommend this one. It has a lot of space. I think the price is reasonable. They have a cute dog. They also have like a gym space and this standing desk, which I also find quite innovating and very fun to use. Using this co-working space, I also got reminded of a problem I forgot about because of the home office, and that is the time. If you spend half an hour getting there and half an hour getting back, it's another hour of your day being lost, and that is quite a lot, especially if you're working out regularly. On Monday, I was working out at Fitness First. They had a limited offer where you could just come over and work out for free. The gym itself is basically like any other gym I've ever seen. The workout itself was quite normal, I guess. There were a few things I learned about recording. First off is that I used a normal phone to record instead of my camera. And that is because if you record yourself with a phone in the gym, nobody really cares. But if you have a camera, then things can get quite awkward. Second is that the workouts are getting longer and longer. And having to deal with large recording files is like really annoying, and also you have to care a lot about having a fully charged battery, otherwise you can not record any longer. Regarding my mobility warm-up this week, I felt a bit better. Wrist circles and pike stand were basically still the same, but I felt a lot better doing the lunge and reach, the archer squat routine where I felt like I could reach more at depth. The hurdle sit switches were basically the pain is now almost gone. The goblin squat, where I could also feel like I am reaching deeper than before. The sitting leg raises feeling easier. Easy bridge was basically still the same. Weighted Jefferson curls feeling much better, and also with a lot of weight. I think next time I can also attempt to do like 30 kilograms. And the caterpillar press and pike press are mostly still the same. A lot of air humping and feeling awkward, I guess. For the main workout, there were 8 sets of pull-ups and dips, 8, which is insane. And at some point I felt like my bones were breaking, but that was probably just in my head because I have absolutely no joint pain at all, which is probably one of the best things ever. Even if I do a lot of dips, I feel no pain. I just feel a bit sore, but that's very good. For the elevated pistol squats, I have mixed feelings. At some points, some days, I can make a very good execution, almost a normal pistol squat. And on other days, especially when I'm sore, it feels like I can't even do the exercise correctly. Archer squat, still very fun to do. I just feel like maybe on Monday and Wednesday I overdid it a bit and should have gone easier on myself. On Wednesday I was working out at the indoor gym of the Hamburger Ding, which was quite convenient because it was in the same building, so I didn't need more time to commute to another place. Once again I had a lot of pull-ups to do, like a lot of pull-ups and also dips, but there was no dip station, so I used the rings, and using the rings is really fun. I wish I could set it up at home somehow. I need to do some research on Google. and I also had a friend join me. For the leg exercises that day, I had a very bad time. I was still sore on Monday and now I was like super sore. Thank God it was dark so I couldn't see myself struggling. On Friday I was at FitX, I still have a membership that is running out in May of 2023. It's basically like any other FitX gym you've ever seen. You have all the equipment you need, like this dip station, lot of pull-up bars, like this innovative bar with balls for climbers or whatever that is. And to be honest, I actually didn't want to go to FitX, but I made a mistake. The Hamburger indoor gym cannot be reached from outside after 6 p.m. You can be inside and train and then leave the building whenever you want, I guess. But you cannot get in after 6 p.m. so I had to go here. And for this workout, we had a lot of pull-ups to do, a lot of dips to do, a lot of step-ups to do, and a lot of bridge raises to do. And it was a good workout. I was expecting myself to be underperforming because I was quite sore, but I could actually do quite a lot of reps. And also not in a bad way, but like with a pretty good form, I would tell myself at least. What I also want to mention here is that if you're doing like a really high number of sets, then at some point you will notice the difference between taking a 2 minute break and a break that is only 1.5 minutes long. In the end, it saves you like 8 minutes and you might be wondering, okay, well, what is 8 minutes? But if you do that on a regular basis, then 8 minutes feels like quite a lot. Trust me. So anyways, here's how my body looks like currently. I lost a little bit of weight, but I don't think it's fat because I ate quite a lot of junk food. Thank you guys for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye.